Hello, I'm broadcasting legend Rick Mercer. You're listening to the Dean Blundell Show on 102.1 The Edge. Some of the material you hear on this program may not be suitable for everyone, like you, in the car with your kids in the back seat. Please do not blame DBS if your kids go to school and they start calling their friends and wallets. Listen with discretion. Thank you.
Hey everyone, it's Dave Grohl from the Foo Fighters.
Hi, this is Christopher Lloyd.
Jason Sudeikis.
Lou Ferrigno.
Hi, this is Adrian Grenier.
Jason Mewes.
Hi, I'm Sean William Scott.
Hi, I'm Rick Mercer.
Yeah, dude, what's up? This is Steve-O.
This is Gilbert Gottfried.
Marcus from Mumford & Sons.
Hey, this is Doug Gilmore.
This is Dancing Monkey, Jay Baruchel.
When I'm not making hit records.
When I'm not hunting quail.
Jerking long balls into the stands at the Rogers Center.
Sleeping in a pool of vomit.
Doing hot yoga.
Playing professional ice hockey.
I'm hanging out with the guys from the Dean Blundell Show.
And I was drunk enough not to care.
Woo! The biggest a-holes in Toronto.
That's what makes me happy.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Happier than a one-legged pig on a fishing trip.
But I'd rather mow my lawn.
The Dean Blundell Show.
102.1 something.
Edge. Woo!
This is your Edge.
Darn it. Hold it.
Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
I got an email the other day. I forgot to read it. Just wanted to thank you for the podcast. Moved to Hong Kong from Oshawa, and the podcast keep me going. Jesus.
Boy, from Oshawa to Hong Kong.
It's a long way to go if you want to go to Hong Kong. It's probably just head up the 407 to Markham.
Same
get a bit, yeah.
Yeah, but maybe the goal was to be just...
Well, and I bet they didn't know that the 407 went all the way there.
Yeah.
Oshawa to Hong Kong. It's 20 minutes.
But you're still 20 minutes away from Oshawa. Maybe that was the
that was a good news. Yeah. It wasn't so much where they're going as where they were getting away from.
Yeah.
That's a good one, yeah. Pennsylvania man proved he wasn't the smartest fella after he went after his housemate with a chainsaw, 76-year-old Guy Allen. If you have housemates at the age of 76, you're a loser. Guy Allen cut through the door of the home he shared with Ron Tanner, then began swinging the chainsaw at Tanner.
76-year-old
Relax, Guy! He was pissed because Tanner changed the locks on the house because Guy didn't pay his rent, you see. Luckily, the saw got stuck on someone's shirt. This is crazy. Got stuck on the guy's shirt that he was trying to attack, this Tanner guy.
Yeah.
And allowed him to fight back. He pinned him with an umbrella. Two old guys going at it.
Really?
An umbrella beats, is like rock, paper, scissors.
Yeah, yeah.
Chainsaw, umbrella, Metamucil.
And you're like, yeah.
Walker. Kane. A great story.
Wow, got him with the umbrella.
Got stuck in his shirt. He reaches for an umbrella and pins him with it.
Although, I mean, how hard would it be to avoid a slow-mo
76-year-old guy?
Yeah, yeah.
Hang on.
Well, it turns out I'm supposed to start the thing before I start waving it around.
Hang on. I got to get my breath. You're going to give me a stick. Give me a break. Here.
It seems your chainsaw is stuck on my shirt. Just back up.
Wait, it's going to give me time and a minute to collect myself and get an umbrella. Let's have a break.
Yeah.
I was thinking the other day, too, if you're 76 and you have a roommate you've lost in life, also if you're over the age of 40 and you need to use a payphone, you've also lost in life.
Oh, yeah. They still have those,
Saw some guy at the 7-Eleven. I actually felt bad for him. I'm like, oh, man, you lost already on that payphone. You lose.
My favorite are the free ones at Jarvis and Shooter.
Oh, yeah.
Then you've really lost it.
Oh, yeah. You're a step below the real payphone guy.
Yeah.
If you don't pay for a payphone, yeah. Got pay as you go?
Forget that. I don't even have 25 cents.
Look, there's the big sign telling me where the free payphone is.
Hey, folks, 85% of your homemade porn ends up on public sites. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, it is crazy. The study analyzed more than 12,000 sexually explicit images uploaded by young people and found the great majority of images have been stolen and published in the Internet Watch Foundation study. Sites called parasite websites exclusively devoted to stealing sexual images featuring people allegedly to obtain the material from anywhere they can get it. Lost or stolen cell phones. They have rewards for that. Hacked in private accounts. Photo Bucket, Flickr, Facebook, Tumblr, whatever. In 2011, the now defunct isanyoneup.com, which, by the way, was pretty funny.
Yeah, that was pretty funny. Because they're like, remember those like gay emo dudes?
Oh, yeah. It's like every dude. Yeah. Like, I left my boyfriend and I just broke up. And this is a jerk.
And it's just a picture of a guy with like 44 lip rings holding a massive wiener.
Oh, weird.
And every one of those emo guys has got a huge wiener.
Yeah, it's true.
And meet Jaggert Washington. What a great name, Jaggert. High on PCP, he tried to gnaw off his own wrist when he was left in a holding cell. He pooped in the back of a city cruiser and for the grand finale bit off and swallowed his own finger.
Wow.
That is high. And that guy was high. Police said the 29-year-old New Jersey guy, under the influence of PCP, drug that causes hallucinations, makes people violent. He first attracted attention when he got naked in the middle of a busy intersection and started attacking cars with his bare hands and pulling on his penis.
I could be crazy, but I think that guy's losing it.
Yeah, probably.
At one point, he allegedly jumped onto the hood of a roof of a passing car and tried to yank the driver out as he was feverishly rolling out the window. He said,
oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus.
Yeah, that would not get up fast enough, eh, that window?
Mm-mm.
The driver fought him off. Cops got there about 5 minutes later. He saw the cops, crouched into a fighting stance, and said to the cops, come on, come on.
Awesome. Yeah. I wish I saw this.
Oh, they came on and they came on. God. They beat the hell out of him. He became belligerent, spit at officers after he's detained, ate his medical bracelet in an attempt to escape handcuffs, began chewing on his own wrists, unable to keep him from hurting himself or others. The officers then put him in leg irons and like four more restraints. He was brought to the jail cell. On the way to the jail, he pooped in the back of the squad car and bit off his own finger.
Really?
And swallowed it.
Wow. This guy would have been a great fight against the basalt guy.
Oh, yeah. In this corner,
PCP. Those are your Edge Files, whatever the hell day it is in October, the year 2012.
The Edge Files on 102.1. The Edge.
Okay, ready. I'm Bam Margera here with.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah. Go ahead.
Is that cool?
Yeah.
I'm Bam Margera here with
Johnny Knoxville. And you're listening to The Dean Blundell Show on 102.1 The Edge.
Big time.
You guys watch the debate yesterday? Watch a little bit of the debate?
Bits and
just
pieces.
The highlights.
Yeah. It was the least most tweeted about. I guess Twitter activity can kind of denote exactly how popular or how interested everybody is in it, and they follow that pretty closely. Least most tweeted, Twittered, followed, flulered. Least most twatted about. I watched part of it, and you know, the thing about when you watch two guys, two grown men in their 40s and 50s argue, doesn't instill confidence in anybody. But, you know, having said that, obviously that this is the way that's always been done. But Obama clearly looked like he was probably more in control of the conversation. Mm-hmm. And he does have a lot more experience. It was easy for him to do. Mitt Romney, hell, I just have a real problem with a guy named Mitt. I don't know. Because because apparently it's his middle name. I don't know if you know that.
I didn't know that. No.
First name, Harry.
Harry Mitt.
Harry Romney.
I see. Harry Mitt.
Oh, sorry, I wasn't thinking.
Of course. That's a great name.
You know,
you should have gone with the Harry Mitt. Mitt Romney. Yeah.
President Harry Mitt Romney. Anyway, Donald Trump yesterday said he's. Did you hear about this guy? Did you hear what he said?
No, I read a lot of his tweets regarding this, but anyway.
Yeah, the information he has information concerning the president of the United States, Obama. He hates Obama.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Says he's going to reveal it. Trump called, you know, it's huge information when Donald Trump calls TMZ.
Who do I got this information out to? The TMZ. Credible news organization.
Hey, they've broken more stories than a lot of the major news agencies.
No, that's true. Too, so. He called TMZ and told them he has information nothing short of a, quote, big fact. Saying, I don't want to comment. It's up to him. Trump describes his information to Fox and Friends, saying it's something very, very big concerning the president of the United States. It's going to be very, very big. I know one thing. You will cover it in a very big fashion.
Here's what you're going to do. You're going to cover this?
Yeah.
In a big fashion.
We'll have a soiree.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, this is the same guy who tweeted about RPATS and K-Stew getting back together. Giving him advice.
It's big news for him.
He was like giving advice to RPATS on Twitter.
Yeah. He's a bitch.
He's like, you should not take back Kristen Stewart. She cheated him like a dog, and we'll do it again. He can do it much better.
You think Donald Trump has stuck his thing in everything he can?
Yeah.
You think really? Like, he's a guy that you need to be taking advice from. He's awesome.
You got to follow him on Twitter.
I'm going to follow Donald Trump on Twitter today. He is the best.
He rips Obama like every other tweet, basically.
He is awesome, though. Well, like if I hate him, I don't like not hate. I don't hate Donald Trump, but he is so crazy, like a fox. He understands how to make money and he knows how to make news, and that's all he's concerned with doing. I remember when he got into it with Rosie O'Donnell, called her a fat pig. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
And then she had a heart attack, and he wished her well. And then about 3 days later, he's like, "I'm not surprised she had a heart attack. She's a fat pig." He did it again. It was like, I hate you. I'm sorry you had a heart attack. Yeah, you're still a fat pig.
Hey, Luther Rick, no. The Todd Shapiro of Comic-Con festivals. You're listening to The Dean Blundell Show on 102.1 The Edge.
We talked before about these websites called parasite websites that apparently offer money, pay for, have software that enables people to share naked pictures of people that have pissed them off, or their own naked pictures, or pictures that you found on a... And I found, you know, it's funny. It was in your parking garage the other day. I found a USB port.
Oh, did you really? Wow.
I gave it to a security guy because I'm like, I don't even want to know what's on this
thing. That's good. Man, good for you.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Because
the last thing you need is to plug that in and have a whole bunch of stuff get downloaded, like, you know, top secret, war secrets and crap like that, or naked pictures of someone you don't want. Anyway, it's actually a pretty fascinating thing. I guess there's a bounty for like cell phone, naked amateur cell phone pictures. You get paid for that. They look for college age students. And one of the sites that they used, which a parasite website, was isanyoneup.com. Hmm. And it's funny because we've all been on that site. Mm-hmm. Like we've all looked. We've all seen. Oh, look at these guys. And usually, as Todd pointed out earlier, just a bunch of guys with big wieners that are emo. And then a bunch of girls that like showing their bum. But either way, it's just, you know. And so it goes back to not how to protect yourself from it. Is there really a point to taking a picture of your wiener and then steaming it over to some chick on a text or an email? Is there really a point of you taking a picture of your privates as you do some stuff, ladies, to send them to some guy who's like, hey, send me a picture. I want to see that. No, there really is no point.
Especially with your face in it or any sort of verifying
marks.
Yeah.
You know. Like your living room or a dog.
A birthmark.
A tattoo with your name on it and a family crest.
But on another, look at family,
your social insurance number.
Your mom right beside you.
Yeah. Yeah, you know. Oh my God, what are you doing?
But they're saying, I mean, that in 20 years from now, no one, absolutely no one, is going to be able to run for president or prime minister.
Oh, yeah. No, because everybody's going to have pictures of their dong on the internet.
Exactly.
Well, maybe that's how they'll win. Ultimately.
Maybe that's what Donald Trump is saying he's got on Obama. He says he's got a big fact.
Oh, he'll win then for sure.
Huh. It's a fact. I have pictures of President Obama's wiener. Anyway,
I wonder if his things are turning gray down there too.
I don't know. wonder what Donald, the Donalds for sure get pictures of it. Hulk Hogan didn't know he was being taped. People do this all the time. So what I thought I'd do is let you tell me your stories, friends, because those are real. 416-870-EDGE, 870-3343. You have an issue with nudity on your phone. Someone sent you some. You sent it to the wrong person. Someone stole yours. An ex. That's always the bad one. See, this is why you should never send pictures to somebody you're not married to. Even if you are married to that person, you step out or they get pissed off and they send it to everybody on your youth group church mailing list. It's a picture of you holding a stuffed animal, some lubricant in the other hand with a massive wiener. Come on.
Or have you ever been on a site and found a picture of yourself?
Oh, that would be the best.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Or if, like, somehow your grandfather tells you.
I saw you.
What are you looking at?
I was looking at bingo numbers the other day. Yeah, sure. I saw your ass. Yeah.
On an Asian porn site. Yeah.
Bingo. Yeah. It's called bingo. Bingo XXX.
416-870-870-3343. Bad experiences with your own or someone else's, you know. Not professional nudity. It's true, though. I've said it like a million times. Just don't do it. Then you have nothing to worry about. I'll be able to run for prime minister for sure. I don't have any pictures of my dong floating around out there. I can say that with confidence. Or my nuts or my butt. Nothing. No videos. Unfortunately, Todd's got several hard drives stored.
I don't even know what you're talking about. What are you talking about?
You will never be allowed to run for any public office. You won't even be allowed to run for the member of your condo board.
Speaking of members.
Bad homemade porn experiences coming up next. And ones that get shared, too. Whoa, that's bad. Time for traffic. Aj, you start. What's your bad homemade porn story?
I have none. I don't do.
You
I
have
don't
friends that do that. You get friends that have been. Yeah. And they've been snagged.
Foolish. Yeah.
They take pictures
and they send stuff to people. Yeah. I've had people send me stuff.
Like guys?
Yeah.
Send pictures of your wiener?
Yeah, I don't get that. Not fun.
Get out of here.
It's like I'm having breakfast and about it.
They send it to you at breakfast? Man,
huh. Yeah.
That's a bad time to get a picture of a wiener.
It's like, good morning. Yeah.
Good morning.
Good morning. How about it?
What'd you do? Was it like a boyfriend or just some guy?
No, it's some randoms. Yeah.
Well, you just give your number out to guys?
Well, you know, you know.
What? Sometimes at a bar, a guy gets your number, and then boom, here's a picture of my
wiener. No attention.
Skip the first part these days, don't they?
Yeah,
like getting to know you?
Yeah, there's no courting. It's just, here it is.
Here's my...
Here it
is unbelievable, too, for both women and men who would rather send you a picture of themselves naked than actually just call you and say,
how are you? Yeah.
So we met at the bar the other night. I was going to send you a picture of my dink, but I thought I'd just call you instead.
Here's my DNA.
Yeah. You go right from there to here's my DNA.
Yeah, is that the next? You put that in a Pure Later package?
Yeah, sure.
You'll be receiving some semen later on in the afternoon. If they're not homeless, leave it at the door, or they'll just take it right back. You got to sign for the for the spunk.
It's in a Jack in the Box, though. So it really comes at you.
The North Broadcasting System presents
the Dean Blundell Show.
Going to be a super duper program for you.
102.1.
Hello. Yes, welcome to the program. Internet pornography and you. Why you shouldn't post pictures of your penis. Or if you found a phone with pictures of someone's penis, you shouldn't share those pictures.
Is it good money, though, if you...
Yeah.
No, I don't think it's my backup plan.
Hey, The Edge.
Good morning. How are you guys?
Good. Who's this?
My name is Ann.
What's up, Ann?
Well, I've had a horrible experience with naked pictures on the internet.
Okay.
Cool.
About 12 years ago, I was moving from British Columbia to Ontario for my third time, and I had gotten, you know, pretty drunk, went out, hooked up with somebody, and went home, had sex with them. Turns out their friend was in the closet taking pictures. Posted them on the internet, and thankfully at that time I had no tattoos. I've got 7 of them now, so thankfully I didn't have those at that time.
So, how did you look in the pictures?
At that time, fantastic.
Okay, so, well, this is the thing. I was just thinking this, actually, because someone sent me an email. It's like, hey, my ex-girlfriend almost gave me the herp. Is a revenge pick in order. And I thought to myself, you know, it depends on what happens, because if you looked awesome in it, and it's a violation and it's totally illegal, but if I looked unbelievable and someone took pictures of me going for it, I would be like, yeah, they're out there. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. It's almost like advertising. It's almost like they're doing you a favor.
Right. And you know what? If I would have known, it probably would have been a different story. It was
exactly. And that's the thing. Exactly. Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, well, did what happened after that? Did you get mad at them and call them, or you had no idea who they were?
Oh, no. I actually went to lawyers and all that kind of stuff and had them taken down and had them prosecuted. So.
Oh, you did?
Wow.
I did. Yeah.
Good for you. What happened to them? Did they go to jail?
No, they didn't go to jail or anything like that, but they did get fined and stuff. So, yeah.
Yeah, good for you.
Taken down and, yeah.
Good for you for following up. Not a lot of people do that. They just go, oh, they're out there now. Forget it.
Boy, uploading all those pictures 12 years ago must have taken a long time.
Especially in, like, yeah, in the sticks.
Those 56K modems.
You have mail. You have porn.
Yeah.
At the Edge.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Good. Who's this?
It's Katie.
What's up, Katie?
I just have a quick story for you.
Sure.
My girlfriends and I, we go to on vacation every year. So obviously those pictures, they get posted on to Facebook. And I was on one of those third-party internet websites to watch movies on them last summer. And one of my girlfriend's pictures popped up on the side, said, looking for a good time, click here.
Wow.
And it's her in a bathing suit from one of our Cuba pictures.
Whoa.
So when you click it, it actually brings you to her Facebook site to add her as a friend. So just a heads up for if you've ever had any of those random add friends, probably from one of those third-party sites and creepy guys adding you trying to get some.
You know what's funny is that there's a girl that follows me on Twitter, and she like tweeted me. This is probably 3 years ago when I first started on Twitter about wanting to like do it. And I'm like, who the hell is this kid? And then so she's tweeted me randomly from time to time, and nothing salacious or anything anymore. But you know when you go on TubeBait,
yeah,
and it's you have these friend finders,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
And this was a year or two ago. So I remember going on TubeBait one morning here at work, and we were looking for something, whatever it was, porn, and the picture of this girl showed up. She's like, I'm looking for a guy, and I'm like, this is unbelievable. How do they get? And what they do
is they take
the hot chicks from up there. Yeah.
Yeah, Facebook sells the pictures to the sites of all the hot girls.
Oh, they do.
Oh, I didn't realize they sell it.
Once you put your I don't know if they sell it, but once you put your picture on Facebook, it's automatically like they own the rights to it, so they can do whatever they want with it.
Is that ever funny?
Well, mine turned up on a gay porn site, but I just use that as an excuse.
Or bait. At the Edge.
Hi, good morning.
Morning.
This is a funny story about my brother. He works at the IT shop. How they get people that bring in their computers and want their hard drive saved. And that includes pictures and all that. But you get lots of nice pictures of girls and... But this is two gay guys who wanted their thing saved, and they had a file that was passworded, and they wanted those pictures, and they're doing it with a cat.
Really?
I didn't think they liked that.
I know. especially with all that hair.
He actually showed us his
hair. Yeah, I guess he did. Like a little pussy cat in the picture hair.
It was terrible, man.
Yeah, did they get arrested?
Well, he didn't know what to do, so he's talking about it with our family. He says, call the cops, man. That's nasty. You can't do that. So they called the cops, and when the guy came in to pick up the computer, he got busted.
Yeah, with two gay guys and a cat.
That's the only way.
It's the only way pussy would make it into them pictures. You know what I mean?
Two girls, one cop. Two gay guys, one cat.
Two gay guys, one pussy cat.
But it's pretty awesome when you get the girls from high school you used to know, and they're dropping their computers off.
Yeah.
So it's we know now where not to go, apparently. Listen to this guy.
So how illegal is what your brother's doing?
Not illegal at all, yeah.
He doesn't. It's not illegal to see them. If you're fixing them, you have to be able to see some of this stuff. What's illegal is this guy sharing the pictures with his brother.
Exactly.
Dude, you got to have a computer guy you trust come to your house and do it. You can't drop your computer off if you got stuff on it.
I always say you just buy a new one.
Yeah, just use a magnet.
Hi, The Edge.
Hello.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good, man. What's up?
Good. That first chick with a hard ass, man.
What?
That first chick, the first caller, was a hard ass, man. She's no fun.
What do you mean she's no fun? She had someone invade her privacy and take pictures of her in a closet on the internet.
She's no fun, man.
At the Edge. At the Edge. Hey.
Hey. I went to the bus stop once and I found this cell phone and I wanted to
return it, but they canceled the plan.
Yeah.
So I ended up snooping through it, and it's got all these videos on it and text to, like, some chicks that he's cheating on. And I watched one of the videos, and I threw that phone away.
Why? Was it that dirty?
Oh, yeah. And I was, like, 12 at the time, and he's getting his, like, trumpet polished and everything.
I was 12 at the time.
No, guy, it scarred him so much. His verbal communication skills are still 12.
Yeah. He was having his trumpet polished and everything.
What did we find his cell phone 60 years ago?
See,
yeah.
He was having his doohickey polished by someone's oral cavity.
Hey, The Edge.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, man. What's up?
Oh, not much. Just calling in for open phone.
Yeah.
I got a story there.
Okay.
So, I'm in high school, about grade 10, and my buddy, who's one of the presidents of the school groups and all that shit, little goody two-shoes guy, we break into a room with a camera and take a picture of him. Well, he's on this girl's and he's got his hand right on her.
I gotta get rid of it. I can't take that call.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, Dean, how's it going?
Good, brother. What's...
I actually have a little story where I actually contacted a girl that had her nudes posted up on the internet.
Well, that's nice of you.
What, to tell her that they were up there?
I was nice about it. I wasn't a pervert. I actually warned her about it because I caught it the hour that it got posted.
How did you know it was her? How did you know her, and how did you put the two together?
Okay, well, you're probably going to want to beep out her name here. I'll tell you, and you could Google it because the picture is still up.
All right.
Her name is...
What a great name. Anyway, go ahead.
So, anyways, I was on his website, and these people posted this picture up, and it has her name and her high school. Plus, some Facebook pictures of her.
Yeah.
And some nudes, some nice graphic ones where she got in a fight with a mail container.
Oh, she's pretty hot if it's the same chick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
she's got one sexy voice too, man.
So what was your intention?
I believe how easy it was to track this girl down.
That's the thing. Think about what this guy's saying. So he identifies this hot chick who's got all kinds of crazy naked pictures, and out of kindness, he just tracks her down. You didn't know her before? You didn't know her at all?
I didn't know her at all. She's actually in Ohio.
Oh, wow.
So you just wanted to let her know that someone put him up there.
Yeah, I just called her, and, you know, she had so much stuff on there. When she was in high school, like 7 years ago, she posted her cell phone number on some website. And just through Googling her name, I was able to get her cell phone number, which is now owned by her brother.
Sounds like you're stalking her a bit, though, too.
Yeah. Maybe she's doing it all on purpose.
I think it would be
stalking. I'm not stalking her. All I know is I'm not stalking her. All I know is that she's wearing SpongeBob pajama pants right now.
She eats Raisin Bran for breakfast.
And her tree, the one limb on the right, is very weak.
The Dean Blundell Show. The Dean Blundell Show on The Edge.
There's a study that came out, said 85% of your pornography ends up on public sites. You can't take it back, kids. So we've been taking phone calls and people telling some wicked stories. Wicked. Oh, hey, who like this? Hey, The Edge.
Hey there. I used to work at Geek Squad.
Oh, dude, and you got story after story.
Wow. Yeah, man. So when I first started there, this is a long time ago now, but this woman came in with her, like, 11-year-old son.
Yeah.
And absolutely freaking out because she had been in a week ago and she had viruses on her computer all over again. Anyway, this kid apparently was surfing for a lot of the anime porn.
Yeah.
And tried to blame it on his you know, his friends in school hacking his phone. But in backing up this computer, I did it with the mom present. So, you know, you could find out whatever she wanted. And we found this hidden folder of her niece who was babysitting this kid. and she's in every position under the sun, using stuff from around the house, you know, that kind of stuff. And she went ballistic.
Hold it, hold it. So the 11-year-old son, obviously, you know, 11, 12, 13-year-old kids are curious, so they look for stuff. But what did that have to do with the niece? Like, was the kid was taking pictures of his cousin?
No, the niece was babysitting this kid and doing stuff after he went to bed. The anime stuff was just the reason that the guy showed up, or that she showed up with the computer in the first place.
And then the niece is over 18 babysitting.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, and taking pictures of stuff. And she uploaded them on this computer, though?
No, she was saving, like, stills on this computer and keeping them in a hidden folder for later.
Jeez. Were they good?
Pretty solid. I'm not
at the edge. Hello.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
Good, brother. What's up?
Long time listener, man.
Thank you.
I'm a network infrastructure technician, but I work at a company called MemoFix. What a MemoFix is essentially it's a company that repairs HP laptops.
Okay.
Okay, so this is a small little company, and they get thousands of HP laptops that come in for daily repairs, whatever it may be. And the best story of it all is there's a program out there called TrueCrypt. Essentially what it does is it makes a file that's encrypted that you can't see, but they can once they mount it using this program. So there's two passwords. One password allows you to get in the file, and there's another password allows you to access the files inside the file, right? Essentially what ends up happening is I was working on a laptop, and I know how to use this TrueCrypt file. And they load a file under the system directory.
Hey, dude, do me a favor. Back off from your phone.
Sorry, back off from my phone?
Yeah, take your mouth away from it a little bit.
Oh, sorry about that. So what would end up happening is when I encrypted this or mounted this file, inside that file, they had like an integer directory. I don't know if you guys know what that website is.
Yeah.
And it was this, I'm guessing soon she was 17 or 18. She just had a folder completely filled and riddled with photos of toys that she was playing with. And I'm assuming she was using a website like Reddit where there's like a slash gone wild or something like that. And it was just riddled to crap. And it was actually pretty great to see. But this was like back in the day. Now in corporate buildings, you don't see this kind of stuff.
Yeah, you can't. You get in super trouble for it. That's the thing. You can't do that stuff on work computers, but you can do it on home computers.
What did he say?
On the edge.
He lost me.
Hello.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm just driving to work, so it's rainy and looks like
yeah.
All right, so I got a good story. I was in high school. I was 19. My buddy's 19. More of an acquaintance. He's dating a 17-year-old. She sends him naked photos. Then about a year later, his mom finds on his computer, they're super religious. So she calls the cops because she thinks that he got these illegally. Turns out it's his girlfriend, 17-year-old, when she took the photos. So he goes to jail for a month, guts into coke, his mom ruins his life.
Yeah, and he gets busted for child porn, right? Because she's under the age of 17. Under the age of 18.
The photos.
Yeah, because she's 17 years old, so the mom totally destroyed his life.
Oh, man. That's a slippery slope right there.
Oh, that'll be the worst. Oh. Your mom sends you in for internet porn, and he get busted for child porn because your girlfriend's 17 and he's 19.
You can't do that, yeah.
Wow. And you're laughing. You must be a great pal.
Oh, no, this is years ago. I don't
know. Oh, yeah, you don't know the guy anymore.
Got a whole new set of friends now.
Yeah, exactly. Hasn't walked right since.
Hi,
yeah.
The Edge.
Hi.
Yay.
How are you this morning?
Good. Who's this?
Sarah.
Sarah. Yes. Sarah, the pot-smoking doobie chick.
Peace and love, my friend.
What's up?
I just called to say hi. It's just kind of funny to get through again.
Do you take naked pictures of yourself?
No. Hmm. I see. I say that, but it's kind of a fib. I have texted my husband.
Naked pictures of yourself.
Not of myself, just of certain areas, you know. Nothing identifiable.
Oh, like a boob.
Oh, that's nothing. No, like a little hoo-hoo.
A little hoo-hoo shot.
Yeah.
Everybody does that. Well, except for me.
Well, you don't have a hoo-hoo.
No. Yeah, that's a good point. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, I got a story for the online news.
Yeah.
So, there's a bar I go to on the regular, and
this guy used to show up all the time in a three-piece suit. And he ended up sending his picture of his junk to a friend of mine. And the thing just looked absolutely nasty. And we have a friend, one of our waitresses there, she's a good friend of mine. She ended up seeing it. She showed it to the other workers at the bar there. So now all the staff have seen it. They've shown it to...
And he has no idea, does he?
Not at the time, no.
Oh, he does now.
Oh, yeah, he knows now. He doesn't even show up anymore.
Of course not.
They ended up showing it to the other regulars. Oh. And once he found out, we ended up finding out that he sent this picture to pretty much every girl that he's ever gotten the phone number there at that bar.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh, guys like that deserve to get caught. At first, you know, you kind of feel bad. You feel bad for the guy. At first, you're like, oh, that's a shame. He's still showing up in a three-piece suit trying to pick up chicks, and he's a total loser. Any guy that shows up to a bar in a three-piece suit's a moron. Just an idiot. Unless, of course, it's after a business meeting with several other guys in a three-piece suit. But if you're going to a bar,
yeah,
getting dressed up in a three-piece suit, you're a dork.
Still not internet dating, at least.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. That's even worse. But imagine sitting there. But if that's your move... You deserve to have that. See, very few people deserve to have their privacy invaded, but if that's your move, if that's what you do...
Sending your thing.
You deserve to have that thing sent everywhere. Because if you're willing to do that as a way to introduce yourself to somebody as opposed to a handshake... It's my move.
It's a lot of people's move.
What do you do? Oh, I send a picture of my wiener. But you don't know her. Yeah. It's my move.
Look at this thing.
Yeah.
The Dean Blundell Show is on the air.
I didn't like it till they got to the flying monkeys.
The Dean Blundell Show.
You can teach a monkey to fly. You can teach a monkey to talk. And this proves it.
102.1 The Edge.
Poor Lance Armstrong.
Yeah. You sure, buddy?
Yeah. Oh, man. Kids, this should be a lesson to you. You can cheat for 20 years, but you'll get caught. Lance Armstrong dropped by Oakley, Nike, his own charities told him to get lost. Cycling yesterday banned him for life. The guy said, there is no place for Lance Armstrong in cycling. No place. He is a cheater. So yesterday he went for a run. Someone took a picture of him while he's wearing a pair of Asics shoes. And they're yellow, just like his Livestrong shoes, right?
Yeah.
So now, and it was funny because I was doing some reading and I thought, they make Livestrong bikes, they make Livestrong clothing, they make Livestrong shoes, they make Livestrong. It's a whole line. It's like a $500-600 million company, $500-600 million industry based on a lie. They stripped him of all of his Tour de France victories. He changed his, this is how you know it's serious, changed his Twitter thing from 7-time Tour de France winner to just Lance Armstrong.
To one ball.
To one nut. Eunuch. One nut Lance. In addition to being banned from cycling, he was stripped of all of his Tour de France titles, plus several major Livestrong sponsors are calling for their money back. He is screwed, claiming they were duped into donating to the charity based on fraud.
But the charity still was for cancer research, though.
Yeah, I don't know if he took the money from the charity. So there is some good that at least came out of this.
They're saying the successes he maintained after going through his cancer, which now some people are questioning if he even went through cancer. That's how ridiculous this has gotten.
Well, you just got to do a cup and feel to prove that one.
Yeah. See that one nut. Go ask Sheryl Crow. Oh, he definitely had it.
Yeah, that slapping was weak.
Yeah, no, my chin never felt it.
Yeah.
So, anyway, he yesterday when he went for his run, he was still wearing his Livestrong bracelet around his wrist. The charity still vowing to continue to make money for cancer research even without Lance Armstrong. He has not apologized, has not admitted, but it is apparently one of the most elaborate doping schemes ever. And Todd was just filling me in. Blood transfusions to try and hide it, getting new blood.
Yeah, blood booster, EPOs, they're doing the steroids and the testosterone, but it was so sophisticated that they were calling it very nasty. That was the International Olympic Committee's medical commissioner.
What, nasty and as just, invasive it,
yeah,
as it was?
Just, it just is, yeah, malicious as it was, basically, to don't cover
like
it all.
Nasty meaning you got to give the guy all new blood, you shoot him with all kinds of stuff.
No, I think he just meant nasty in terms, again, how it was just so, it was just so elaborate to get over these testing schemes. So it was such a ploy to get past it to win.
I want to find out more.
Actually, yeah, we should have a doctor who would understand this sort of stuff on. That'd be interesting.
Yeah, I want to find out more. I'd love to find out. Like, I'd love for the news to come around how his teammates, because they all sold him out. His teammates all said, yeah, we were all on it, too, because he was killing us so bad they had to put us on it.
We had to keep up.
Because we had to keep up. So that's really how they found out, is all of his teammates came forward. Even some Canadian guys like, yeah, we were doping.
Some Canadian guys were doping?
Yeah, one guy from Toronto was part of the team.
Didn't help him.
Yeah, how much of a loser were you?
Yeah, man, I've done all the doping.
If they put you on that crap and you still came in last. At least he won.
That's like finding out some Argonauts are on steroids.
Why? Yeah.
For their second job, though. To work the forklift.
Yeah.
On the Edge.
So the other day, Todd went to Whiskey A Go Go. It's a strip joint. Is it north of the city?
Yeah, it's like Dufferin and 7 area.
Okay. So Todd goes to Whiskey A Go Go. Probably hadn't been there since university, I would say.
Yeah, I still am paying student loans off for those lap dances, actually. And that's the truth. Yeah. I would get OSAP and use them for lap dances.
I know. That's pretty much what everybody did, dude.
Yeah, yeah. Books, schmooks. Come on.
They got photocopiers. Yeah.
Give me Destiny.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And candy.
Yeah.
Good grant this month. Extra dough. So you went to see a dwarf tossing thing, but in the meantime, you also got a chance to catch up and find out legitimately how bright some of these ladies are that are in this field.
Yeah, then just to try and determine if they have a moral compass, seeing if it was like, if they, appreciated or liked or disliked, obviously, tossing a dwarf. So here it is.
All right, gentlemen.
Todd on the street.
What's your name?
Silver.
Silver?
Yeah.
What? Silver, you are, can I look at you for a second? I would say you're the hottest stripper here by far. Have you been told that?
Yeah, I hear that every day.
Tonight you have some sort of contest going on, right?
Yes, we do. We have the midget tossing.
And how do you feel about that on a moral level? Being a stripper, I'm sure you have very high morals.
I think people have to do what they gotta do to make money.
Do you think it's people should be offended by this, by tossing a little person, a midget? Do you think it's taking us back 40 years to the circus days and looking at them like freaks?
I don't think so, because it's his choice.
I see your butting on that is, wow, what is your background? Are you Eastern European?
I am. Yeah.
Yeah, not so. Are you from Hungary?
I am.
Are you actually?
Yeah.
Did your mom have a good ass too growing up?
She's gorgeous, she yes. Gorgeous?
Have you heard about Dalton McGuinty quitting the Liberal Party?
Sure haven't.
Well, do you know the three main parties here in Canada?
Nope.
Have you watched any about the presidential race or the debates going on in the United States of America?
Nope.
Do you know who the president of the United States is?
Obama.
Do you know who's running against him?
Nope.
His name's actually Romney.
Oh, okay.
Can you say that?
Romney.
Yeah, it's me, right? Can you spell dwarf?
D-W-R-V-E-S.
You're good. See, a lot of people give a stereotype that strippers aren't smart. You, while you might not know politics, in your body is unbelievable. Thank you so much.
Kilo, don't distract my DJ.
Oh, I won't distract. Okay.
You can say anything you want, buddy. This is the Whiskey A Go Go. Talking about shaving your
That's amazing. Can you say
Okay.
Oh, those are short shorts, eh? That's really well done.
He's distracted right now.
Yeah, yeah. What a booty. I'm in the stripper's change room. This is neat. It's not every day a guy gets to be here, right?
Sexy bitches. Can I take a picture of you?
What's that? What's that?
Okay. You recording?
I record.
Getting
hit. What's your name?
Was it my real name or a fake name?
I don't care. What's your stripper name?
Tori.
How old are you?
Just turned 28.
How many lap dances did you give tonight?
Snow White on the block.
What? What's that?
Snow White on the block.
Snow White on the block. Snow White on the block.
I don't even know what she's saying. What's she saying?
Snow White on the block.
What's your name, ma'am? You look like Rihanna. You're so beautiful.
Tokyo.
Where are you from?
Brampton. Don't ask me to spell nothing.
Sorry?
Oh, yeah, okay.
What do you want, just some weed?
Yeah.
So what do you think of the dwarf tossing tonight?
To be honest, I thought the little fellow was going to go flying, but they're not really hauling him that far.
I like you.
I mean, it'd be some entertainment, I'm just saying.
How far did you think he would go?
Like 20 feet, I don't know.
Yeah, and how far is he?
Like 8.
That's it? You're so disappointed.
I am.
You're like, you want that midget to fly further.
Yeah, I think it'd be entertaining.
Yeah. Have you ever tossed anything in your life?
Nothing as big as a midget.
Have you tossed a salad before?
No, I don't even know what that means.
Okay. It means eating.
Ew, no!
What about the rusty trombone?
What? What's their, oh.
And it's eating.
Oh my gosh, no.
Can you spell rusty trombone?
I know I can't.
Okay.
Not right now.
Okay, can you spell orange juice? I love
this
strippers.
Too much. So do I.
Do you ever made love to a stripper?
No, but I fantasize about it.
Why don't you do it?
Because Candace doesn't want to do it with me. Ew, no. I would not even try to spell that.
Why is that?
Because it's too confusing. I never had it.
What about penicillin?
Nothing could be spelled right now.
How about fork?
F.
Even better.
Secretly, I do want the dwarf to get hurt. It'd be funny.
I appreciate your candidness and your moral code. And your booty.
B-O-T-Y. God, I know how to spell.
Talk on the street.
On the Dean Blundell Show, gentlemen.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Blue Jays pitcher Ricky Romero. When things get crazy, I like to talk to the guys at the Dean Blundell Show to keep me grounded. Dean's BBMs keep me encouraged throughout the year. And Todd and I, well, we go out dancing in our V-neck t-shirts. And then after, we get shawarmas. Man, are those tasty.
This is the Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.
Hi, The Edge. Hello?
Hello?
Who's this?
Ashley.
What's up?
Hey. How are you?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm terrific, thank you.
Good. What's up?
I was just curious. I was listening to your show, and I thought it was incredibly hilarious listening to Todd talk to those incredibly intelligent people.
Yeah.
And then you guys followed it up with Matt Good. It's so depressing.
I know.
Well, that's what we're... Sorry. Yeah. Hang on, sir. Turn the music off. That's what we're trying to do.
I don't know. I just honestly thought that you guys would play something maybe a little bit more... upbeat.
Yeah, we usually do, but Dickhead here, our producer, he's like, do you want a Matthew Good song? And I said, I didn't care, but I just assumed that it would be a little more upbeat than Apparitions. It would be more than, like, I thought, oh... You'll play the only not suicidal song he sings.
It's not the melancholy program this morning?
No.
No, okay.
In the Verve Bittersweet Symphony, we played that before. Jesus Christ, man. I feel like I'm at some kind of suicide watch prevention conference.
Yeah, I just feel like it's raining, it's crappy, and we should all be pulling out some other blades or something like that.
Fair enough.
Yeah. I
hope there's
it.
No subway stop today.
Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
Who's this?
This is Samantha. How are you?
Good, Samantha. It's Dean. How are you?
I'm good.
What's up,
Toots? I have
Toots?
A really awkward question for you guys, but please. I think that Wednesday's awkward questions, isn't it?
No, it's you know what? Here's the thing. For women, it's every day. Yeah. For guys, it's only one.
Okay. Yeah. I kind of thought so. That's why I called.
What's up?
So I am 4.5 months pregnant.
Mm, good.
And yeah, good for me.
You married?
Me over. I'm engaged.
Okay.
And he suddenly has stopped going downtown.
Of course.
Why?
That's where the baby comes from. There's traffic at the intersection.
Well, there's traffic.
They have teeth, those babies.
No, you know what? It's a mental thing. It's all it is for guys. But, you know, you can make him feel better about it.
Well, I mean, like, I don't want to be like, hey, what's going on? Like, it's all appealing and stuff. It hasn't changed.
Well, yet. It's not. That hasn't changed. No, that won't change until after you squeeze it out. Then it'll look like a catcher's mitt full of lasagna. But the thing is that you've got that thing in the upper part, right? Like, you've got the belly now.
Oh, yeah. It's
so there. It's that's there. It's in its head. It's, you know, it's nothing wrong with him. He's just, have you talked to him about it?
No, I haven't talked to him.
But you'll call me.
Yeah. But I'll call you and go on the air. But I'm talking about it.
Yeah, no, it's all honest to God. It's just a mental thing, I think, for guys. I have a lot of friends that are like that too. And I you know, mine was a completely different set of circumstances, so I don't want to talk about it, but, because it didn't matter what was there. Just like, so the thing about it is, it's a mental thing for him and you need to talk to him about it because you enjoy it, right?
Yeah.
Like, do you prefer that to sex?
Well, no, I just prefer it with it.
Like to do both.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah,
I love it.
How much sex do you guys have now?
Oh, quite regularly.
Like every day?
So hot.
Like every other.
Every other day?
Yeah.
Okay, and he used to go down and do all that stuff, and now he's
kind of... Now. I mean, like, I know that it's just because of baby town.
Yeah.
But still, man.
Is this your first?
Yes, it is.
I just think there's other things you can do in the meantime. How are the boobs? The boobs are probably looking never better.
They're fantastic. I almost want to photograph them for the world.
Oh, see, yeah, send them to us.
No,
yeah.
Don't. To us. Stupid
first
idiot.
First thing I'll do the second I get to work, I promise.
Thought so. Yeah.
Way to go, Todd. Okay, so that's all it is. You find it. It's like playing injured. You know, you have to find a way to just get it done for now. And then in 9 months, 10, 12 months after, tell him, first of all, if he doesn't want to go down and do that while you're pregnant, he does not want to have a look when it's coming out. Otherwise, he's going to be wrecked for life. Because that used to be a play area for him. That used to be a play area for him.
Yeah.
And now it's the scene of a crime when he watches it.
Yeah, right? But and you know what? And I'm not saying this is a pun, but it is a slippery slope. I mean, if he's not doing this now, what you're right, what won't he do later?
Yeah.
Now, was that pun fully intended or did that just
No, I really did. It's. I mean, let's be honest. It should be slippery, but okay.
Yes,
but
if it's not, he's not doing his job.
Yeah. Something's not right.
Good luck to you.
Thanks very much.
Yeah. Take care.
He should be back on that.
I wouldn't be able
maybe
to do
he
it.
Just no. didn't like it in the first
maybe,
place.
Maybe. I don't know. It just seems, you know, for every guy, it's different, I think.
And who am I to talk? I've never been with a girl who's pregnant, so.
Todd.
I fantasized about it.
Yeah, you did. You like pregnant chicks, don't you?
I'm like, stick out your belly. That's how much you put the pillow in there.
Here, eat a lot of this cheese. Yeah. Hey, eat some cheese and rice.
Come
That's
on.
It for a week. Yeah. I want to see you bloated, big time.
And fatigued.
Yeah, you're not going to get pregnant. I want at least, I want a big poop in there. I think I'd have a luck.
And act all irrational.
No. Just come home and start crying at dinner for no reason. I like that. Hey, The Edge.
Hey, how's it going, Ed?
Rational.
Hey, good man. What's up?
Not much. Not much. I just got married in July. And now my wife. Well, she's a good woman. Good woman.
All right.
Okay. And so now we're trying to have a kid. And I'm just curious: is there any position that guarantees a little better than others?
No, there really isn't, I don't think. You know, the ones that I've heard are the bicycle kick ones where you do it and then she gets on her shoulders and puts her legs up on the wall and it kind of drains down, I guess. That's kind of the thing. Doctors will tell you to do that.
Oh, well, we've been doing good because the other day after I grabbed her by the ankles and gave her a little shake.
You know what, though? You know how you'd be a... Come on.
Get down here. It's like she's got change in her pocket.
Yeah.
We're going to have a baby no matter what. And I'm going to get at least $4 in change.
You know how you'd be a true hero, though? If you convinced her is by doing it in the back door.
They'll find their way.
Yeah. I was talking to Dean and the guys, they said the mouth. Like right after.
Long journey.
You remember that story? It was like 10 years ago. One of my all-time favorite stories. It was in Romania, yeah. Where the Romanian couple have been married for 20 years trying to have kids, and they go to the doctor, and they realize after 20 years he's been going to the wrong entrance. 20 years. And then it was too late for him to have kids.
Can't say they didn't enjoy themselves.
Oh, yeah. But you know what? Some people thought, what a terrible tragedy. And I thought, man, that guy is so smart.
I know.
Yeah, he's got a brand new thing for the rest of his life.
Yeah. It's brilliant. Yes. Second win.
It's like you're still 19. Hey, The Edge.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
I just wanted to say that thing was really funny, you know?
What thing?
The last thing that I heard. I'm sorry.
Oh. Who's a Zoolander?
Thank you. I'll use it in my googly.
I've been up drinking and, you know, it's just been one hell of a night.
What do you mean? You've been up drinking?
Oh, yeah. I've been partying, you know?
Yeah.
Been
it's crazy.
The NHL game, seeing as we don't really have an NHL this year. We've relived Stanley Cup memories. It was a great time.
Oh, no doubt. What else?
Hello? Oh, sorry. My phone cut out. But yeah, just wanted to say you guys are pretty funny.
Or lonely. Hard up. Use your free hand and follow the boys on Twitter.
At Dean Blundell Show.
The Dean Blundell Show. 102.1.
The Edge.
This is your Edge.
Got it. Hold it.
Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
San Antonio woman facing charges after police said she faked her own kidnapping to get a day off from work. An officer on patrol went to check a parked car. Around 6:30 p.m., looked inside the car. He spotted 48-year-old Sheila Eubank bound with a rope. An arrest warrant says that Eubank told police a man jumped in her car around 6:15 in the morning while she was at a security service ATM getting ready to go to work. Said the man held a knife and said, you drive me around and we're going to do some drug deals and then you're my driver. She told police he then assaulted her, tried to choke her with a rope and tied her up and left her in the car. However, officers discovered a lottery ticket in her purse that was purchased that day during the hour she claimed she was being held. They also reviewed some surveillance video from the store where the lottery ticket was purchased, found out she entered the store by herself and appeared healthy, unhurried, and very pleasant with the clerk. She also appeared to grab a couple of alcoholic beverages from the back cooler and take those with her. She then fessed up and said,
Yeah. I just went to the park and got drunk all day. I just didn't want to go to work. And I just thought instead of calling in sick, this was a much better idea.
Did she get her own hands?
That's one clever, stupid idiot is what it is. And everybody's favorite trailer family, the Honey Boo Boo family. Honey Boo Boo Child was on Dr. Drew yesterday. You got to watch. Mama June and Honey Boo Boo Child are on Dr. Drew. This is the start of the interview.
Back with Honey Boo Boo Child and Mama June. Honey Boo Boo, you all right?
She's stretching.
Let me ask you some questions, honey. I know. Everybody always wants to talk to you. Is it difficult to be on TV? Is she sleeping?
Yeah.
Is there something exciting you'd like to talk about?
Alana, come on out so we can get this done so we can go.
She's pretending to be asleep and looking at people, like closing her eyes with her mouth open and in Dr. Drew's face. And then turns and looks at her mom, does the same thing. Like, I'm awake, but I'm pretending to sleep because I don't want to answer these questions because I'm just a little trailer trash on the bench.
I thought she was just talking to her mother in her mother language.
Huh? You that?
Hi. Hi.
Stop, don't hit.
It's all right. She's not hitting me.
She hit him in the face.
Tried to.
Do you like being on TV?
Do you like being on TV? And riding races? No!
You don't like it. Tell me. How come?
Because fans come up to me and I hate it.
You hate it?
Yeah, right.
You hate it, fans.
Oh my goodness. What did she say?
They really do need it.
Translator. They need like a trailer to English translator for these.
Child and Mama June.
So just to set the stage, Honey Boo Boo doesn't want to talk. So she's six and she's already a bit of a bench. She doesn't want to talk. So she just sits there and doesn't say a word. Pretends to sleep.
Back with Honey Boo Boo Child and Mama June. Honey Boo Boo, you all right?
She's stretching.
Let me ask you some questions, honey. I know. Everybody always wants to talk to you.
7 million people watch this. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Stretching.
Stretching.
Let me ask you some questions, honey. know, everybody always wants to talk to you. Is it difficult to be on TV? Is she sleeping?
It's pretty funny. It's pretty funny.
I know. Is there something exciting you'd like to talk about?
Yeah.
Alana, come on out so we can get this done so we can go. Hmm. Huh? Get up.
Hi.
She's pretending to go. Yeah,
that's right. Pretending to be asleep. Pretending to just wake up.
Oh, no, no.
Do you like being on TV?
Do you like being on TV? And running races?
No!
You don't like it? Tell me. How come?
Because fans come up to me and I hate it.
You hate
yeah.
that?
Yeah.
You hate
yeah.
it, man.
Where are the subtitles when you need it? What'd she say there?
Fans come up to me and I hate it.
Yeah. Oh. Hey, when she first says the mother, when she goes stretching, is she talking about her clothes?
Oh, my God. She looks honestly like a Big Mac with legs, the mom.
Grimace.
Those are your Edge Files, whatever the hell day it is in October, year 2012.
The Edge Files.
On 102.1.
The Edge.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Dean Blundell Show.
On 102.1, The Edge.
Welcome to the Dean Blundell Show. Today, we'll be opening up the phone lines to find out a little bit more about you. What's wrong with you? Why are you so different from normal people? What happened in your life to make you so odd? Please join us, won't you?
Oh, I gotta turn my mic on, too. Hi, The Edge.
How's it going?
Good, what's your name?
Jimmy.
How old are you?
I'm 34.
Huh. Time maybe to just go with Jim?
Yeah. I'm Jimmy.
What's that?
My birth name's James, but...
Oh, is it? Yeah, it's my dad's birth name is James. I call him Jim or Jimmy, but...
There you
but
go.
He's like 61, so that's a kind of an endearing thing. But at the age of 30, do you make your friends call you Jimmy?
Yeah.
He's honest.
I don't make them. They just call me Jimmy. I don't.
All right.
Jimmy!
That's what I say when I call my dad. Jimmy! Anyway.
What the
Oh, it's what's wrong with you. What's Never mind. What's wrong with you, sir?
Well, I'll start it off with I just got diagnosed with MS.
That's a good one.
Oh, man.
Well, not really a good one, but...
Well, it's a good start to the contest. It's yeah. a terrible result, but good start to the contest.
Okay, so yeah. before I found out that I had it, mm-hmm. so multiple sclerosis obviously attacks multiple different parts of your brain. So it also attacks your bowels and stuff.
Oh, no.
So one time I was going to do a job in Vaughan, couldn't quite make the red light.
Yeah.
And I really had to go, so I blew the red light, and I went into a Tim Hortons.
Lucky red light.
Yeah, no, right?
I bet you turned green.
With envy.
So if you ever watched the movie Dumber and Dumber, you know the scene where he went to the washroom?
Yep.
Well, it was basically like that, but in the Tim Hortons washroom. And I was wearing my work clothes and trying to get off work pants when you got work boots on, when you got a load of crap in your pants.
Oh, it's dumber.
So I was trying to take them off, and a cop came in the door because he heard me screaming. So next thing you know, I'm trying, and I mean, there's crap all over the back of the toilet, all over the wall.
So can I'm sorry, just going to tell you this because I don't know, and I apologize. I'm sad to hear that you got MS. But what happens when it attacks the bowel and the brain? You mean like your bowels stop working, your brain stops working? Is that those are parts of MS?
Yeah, like basically with mine, it's just like my leg's shot right now. My vision's going to my left eye.
How long is that? Does that ever get better or no?
No, whatever happens, like...
is permanent.
Like, well, like, they call them souvenirs. Not my idea of a souvenir shop.
No, but. No, usually they come in, like, souvenirs or, like, you know, you get, like, yeah. a little spoon.
Give me a freaking spoon or something.
Yeah, from Banff.
Did you catch it early, though? Because the one thing I understand about MS, if you get it fairly early, you can maintain it a bit and control it.
No, well, the thing is, I've had it for around 8 years now, but I just found out this summer. Yeah, so I've been going through doctors, and every doctor's like, sorry, but yeah, I've never heard of this before. I don't know what's going on. So they'd send me for this test, send me for that yeah. test.
Yeah. All right. So you pooped yourself at a Tim Hortons, and you got MS.
And there's crap everywhere. And I yep. mean, I had to take my underwear off, and you know those garbage cans that have the swinging lids?
Mm-hmm.
So when I went to go throw my underwear in there, it swung off there and splashed all over the wall, the floor.
Yeah, I get it. I get it.
Blah, 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 blah. Yeah.
Hi, The Edge.
How's it going, boys?
What's up, bro?
Not too much, man. This is my first time getting through. I'm so excited.
Don't swear.
My bad. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Okay. I have a very dirty story for you guys. This happened just over this summer.
I was in a, I was camping with my girlfriend, bunch of my family, friends, stuff like that. And we, you know, we're in the tent and it's just her and I, you know, we do a bit of backdoor loving. And, you know, something came by the tent and I thought it was one of our friends or one of my families, AKA like my mother or my sister.
Or so maybe mention some other family members.
Yeah.
You know, like maybe my niece. I don't know. Somebody is freaking me out. I don't know.
That's clever, eh? That's, I'm a pretty clever guy. Yeah. Clever guy.
So boring.
And I just knew, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
right. Did you know too?
Pretty sure. Yeah.
By the edge.
I thought you were going to play the Honey Boo Boo Sleeping, actually.
Hey. Hey, dude.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. What are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just in school right now, but I'm going to tell you how my life sucks right now.
What's wrong with you? Yeah.
Well, I got kicked out of my house. I came home from school one day, and I decided to read a GQ, lay on the couch, and it happened to be the GQ of Zach Galifianakis.
Yep.
And so I decided to take a nap, and I have a problem with talking in my sleep. And I've been listening to the show a lot, so I know the get down, oh, open your mouth. So as I'm reading, I take a nap, and I have the full page cover of Zach Galifianakis open. And in my sleep, I start chanting that. And my dad walks in, he sees me in my boxers with Zach Galifianakis front page cover. And he thinks I'm a homosexual, so he kicked me out of the house.
That's almost as good as MS.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a tough one.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, I'm calling in for What's Wrong With You?
Yeah, what's wrong with you?
Well, I called in about a year ago. I had the two hairs growing out of my urethra.
Yeah.
And I actually since went in and had them burned, so the follicles were sealed. And when the guy went in, I don't know if he touched a nerve or something, but now I get like crazy swass. My ass just sweats like crazy all the time.
Yeah.
And he burnt the side of my shaft with the soldering iron or whatever the hell they used when I was out.
Soldering iron.
Whatever it was that they burned it with. So now every time I sit in a Hummer, there's a big, huge red mark on the side of my shaft that I got to try to explain while my ass sweats all over the place.
That's unlucky.
Mm. Yeah. What is that?
Some snoring sound it's effect. Awesome. It's like a cartoon one, though. Yeah.
I like it.
You never know what's going to be funny here.
Hey, The Edge.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good, what's your name?
Elliot.
What's up, Elliot? What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm transgendered. That's about it. That's all I got.
So, hold it. Transgendered, meaning you were born with male and female parts?
No, I was born female.
You're born female, but you sound like a dude.
Yeah.
You're a dude.
No,
so you have a vagina?
You want to call it that?
Well, what do you mean, what do you want to call it that? What else do you call it?
Gross.
Well, it was one.
Oh, you had it changed over?
No, actually. Soon enough.
Did you have, you're on the hormones, so the thing gets longer, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So how long is your wiener?
really don't want to talk about that. It's really nothing to talk about, really.
But you called us.
Yeah.
No, I know, but, like, it's nothing.
How old are you?
I'm 25.
25.
But you have the China, the wrestler thing.
Yeah.
Where it looks
a
like...
A longer thing. You have a longer thing that looks like a... Are you going to get full-on surgery to get a thing, a real one?
Yeah, dude. I will.
Are you going to get nuts?
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, wow.
Good job.
Do you have boobs already?
No.
Gone?
What?
Gone. You got rid of your boobs?
She's sorry, I'm
turning into a male.
Yeah, man.
So you had them taken right off. You don't be embarrassed. This is cool. This is a part of life. It's who you are.
No, I'm just worried because I'm not out at work. So,
people think you're a dude at work. They didn't know. They don't know that you used to be a girl.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
What washroom do you use?
The male washroom.
Wow.
Do you use a urinal?
No.
Can you though? If you try.
No, I'd pee all over myself.
What's your name?
Elliot.
So they're like, oh, Elliot's going to poop again.
Someone's in the stall.
This is a tough one because we got someone with MS.
Yeah.
Zach Galifianakis.
Zach.
I do have a backstory. Like, I pissed myself at work.
Yeah.
I had to pee so bad, and nobody knows at work, so I literally had to pee myself because I couldn't just whip it out like most people.
So did you, what did you say? Oh, I spilled water?
Yeah, pretty much. I like walked around with a sweater tied around my waist for the rest of the day.
Mm-hmm. So do you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend?
I have a girlfriend, actually.
You have a girlfriend. Does she know that you are used to be a woman?
Yeah, 100%.
And she's totally cool. You sound like, yeah, you win. That's...
You're yeah. the winner on the Dean Blundell Show! Yay!
I imagine, you know, the social implications of going from guy to girl are a lot greater than pooping yourself at a Tim Hortons, even if you do have MS. Do you know what I'm saying?
He's going girl to guy.
That's harder to do.
Yeah.
Girl to guy. But you're, so does that make you a lesbian, or because of your mind you live as a guy, you're just straight?
I'm actually legally male, so technically I'm straight.
Legally male because you had your breasts removed?
Yeah.
Did you have big nice boobs?
Totally, yeah.
Dad. Dang it. It's like an abortion.
Like double D's.
Really?
Double D's?
Yeah.
So how did anybody notice, or did you just start a new life?
I basically started a new life. Like I started hormones and then I like quit my job and worked something completely new where nobody
Did you have to move?
No, I actually live in the same place I grew up, which is kind of weird because then I'll go to, like, the mall and I'll be like, I need to go to high school with that person.
Do they recognize you or no?
No.
Well, it's kind of like Halloween every day.
Yeah.
Trick or treat.
So can I ask you a question? And I'm fascinated. I think it's great. I think it's you're probably much, much more comfortable now than you've ever been, right?
Am I on the air right now?
Yeah, totally.
Oh, sorry. I don't mean to swear.
That's okay. No one knows your name. So you probably much more comfortable than you were before when you were a female, right?
100%.
Okay, so now because of that, and you get to live like this, do you think that you're going, because now you have a choice, do you get to choose the size of your member when you get one?
Well, there's different options. The one option I'm going for, they actually just use what you have and, like...
Do they have, like, you can go this or you can go Mandingo?
Yeah, like, it's actually easier for a male to turn into a female. As
yeah.
So, yeah. There's, wow.
Get a
there's
big not- one.
Hey, how embarrassing is that?
Get the biggest one you can get.
For a guy with a tiny one? And it's yeah. Like, oh, that guy used to be a chick.
And it's bigger.
It's twice the size.
This is the Dean Blundell Show.
I'd say as far as stripper, slow stripper songs go, that'd be like number one or two.
Yeah. I mean, Stairway to Heaven works just because it's longer.
Yeah. But they always cut those yeah. short.
I know. Yeah. What a rip-off. Especially when you get in the lapper, you're like, oh, sweet, six
yeah,
minutes.
Stairway.
Yeah.
9:42, good morning. Time to take some phone calls. Hey, The Edge.
How you doing?
Good, how you doing?
Not too bad. Took the day off of work to go into another job because the economy is the way it is.
Hmm. So where do you work now? What do you do now? Don't tell us where you work. What do you do?
Short order cook.
So you're going to go find another cook job?
Actually, change of pace, maybe something that isn't so much of it daytime.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm actually on my way to a mechanic shop.
Oh, good. Do you know what you're doing in a mechanic shop? You can fix a car?
I have some recent experience, plus my girlfriend's dad's a mechanic, so he helps me with a lot of stuff that I need help with.
All right.
Okay. So it's all good.
I know, man.
So what's going on with you guys?
Were you hoping for our help or something? Or?
I don't know. I think you just wanted to chat.
Yeah.
I got an email from Mike because we were talking about sending nudies this morning. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's bad. 85% of your homemade stuff somehow through these sites called parasites where they pay for stolen material and they've got search things that go and these malware and different things that go in and they steal your pictures and then they post them and... Hey, Dean, sending nude photos is how I found out my ex-wife was having an affair with my neighbor. His wife went through his phone call one morning while he was over-effing my wife when she found a bunch of sex texts and nude pics on his phone. Needless to say, it all came out that day about the affair because I was at work when they got busted, but I found out that night after work. So, yes, don't send photos to anyone, at least definitely not someone you're married to. Because this Mike guy, yeah, I think, also has naked pictures of his ex-wife, and I'm sure he shared them. That's how mad he was. You can never, ever take those back either. Once they're taken and sent, the second you press send, you're screwed. So keep that in mind.
It's usually just a pecker.
By the edge.
Hello?
Hi, who's this?
This is Millie. How are you?
Good, Millie. How are you?
Very, very good. Hey, I just going to say thank you, guys, because I win the tickets for the Argos. I went with my friend.
Yeah.
And I had so much fun. I never went to a football game before, and it was, well, I didn't understand what it is. But anyway, I had fun anyway.
Where are you from?
I'm from Peru, actually.
You're Peruvian.
Yes, I am.
And you were the one that called in, if I'm to remember correctly, that liked this. This clip here.
Open your mouth.
That one?
Oh, God. Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
I like it when she said it, though. When she was...
Yeah, you do it. Do your imitation. Turn the music down.
Good on.
But didn't she not like it? Because it would have happened. She would think of it while she was doing that with her boyfriend, and then it would make her like want to stop
start
or
laughing.
Throw up.
She'd just start laughing. But do it again. Do it again. Come on. Do it.
Oh my God, you guys. Good dog.
Open your mouth.
Anyway, I know how to say that. Come on. This Smashing Pumpkins is the 25th, and that's my birthday.
Oh, thank wow. How old are you going to be?
I'm going to be 31.
All right.
Yeah, I'm so happy. Thank you, guys. And actually, my husband, he said he's going to sing happy birthday. Happy birthday. Get down to you. Get down.
Oh, come on.
She get him to throw in a little bit of this, too.
Open your mouth!
Kind of all has to do with blowing out a candle, right?
Yeah. Finger licking good!
Hi, The Edge.
How's it going?
Good.
Good. This is the MS man calling back.
Oh, you lost, to the transgendered person.
That's
sorry.
That's all right, though, because you want to know what? Any woman that's willing to trade her for a unit to have to put up with women's crap for the rest, nagging for the rest of his life, that's a guaranteed winner, man.
Spoken like a true douche.
You gotta
any maybe guy, CMS talking.
Any guy that's willing to cut off his own, any girl that's willing to cut off her boobies and become a dude and put up with other women's crap his whole life, that's a winner right there.
I thought he was gonna say like having to deal with these like dangly weird things.
Well, that's in itself is not a good proposition. If that's not enough to turn you off becoming a man, if you want to be a man and you are a woman. You know, come over here. We'll tell you some first world problems with penises. They hang, they hit, they hurt. Nuts are a terrible thing. You sit on them, you hit them, you graze them, and it's over for like 3 hours.
They grow when you're at a business meeting. They're not supposed to.
Church. Derek, you ever get a boner in church?
No. Well, I do, but usually it just means I have to go to the bathroom.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey.
How's
it going?
Good.
So I have a story.
Yeah.
Well, I've only got one nut.
Why?
Last September, I was diagnosed with testicular cancer.
Yep.
The whole Lance Armstrong thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it left me with one nut. And after the second surgery, I wasn't able to produce manly fluid anymore. Yeah.
So you can't have kids?
No, I can't.
Okay.
Did you store any, though, before it?
Yes, I did. I banked some.
Mm-hmm.
So my question is, when I'm getting it on with a girl for the first time, do I tell her or do I let her find out for herself?
I think you tell her.
Yeah?
But I don't think you tell her like you make a big deal out of it. There's two ways you can do so you can reveal information. One is you make a big deal out of it and freak someone out, or two, go, hey, I got one nut. Do you have a girlfriend now?
No, I do not.
Okay. Are you seeing anybody?
Not yet.
Okay, well, you know, when the time comes.
Dude, you're dead on with that advice, too.
Yeah.
Just matter-of-factly.
Dude, yeah. All it is the bigger deal you make. This is advice for everybody today, folks. Brilliant. Take this away with you. If you have something like, let's say you got herpes or you got one nut or you got, one side ladies hangs lower than the other or one boob's a lot smaller than the other and you're all self-conscious about it, A, there's different ways you can tell people how to do it, and B, this is a good way to own it. You go, hey, you're talking about Lance Armstrong. You call him your brother. My brother. Brother Lance. Know. Yeah, yeah. You just... Or mention it in passing. You don't have to make a big deal out of it. And she goes, if she says to you, you only have one nut, just say, yeah.
Can you still...
Who cares? I bag some spluke.
Can you still... Do you still kind of sort of climax when you're having
sex? Yeah, like there's all the...
There's no
like,
soldiers.
Well, that's perfect.
It's like having a vasectomy before you have kids, right?
But there's no liquid at all.
Nothing. So, oh, you're dry so heaving.
Blank.
Your wiener dry heaves.
But I think that's awesome.
Boy. It's
like this.
Oh, boy.
Dude, man, I think just be exact. And you know what? If she makes a big deal of it after you just tell her, whoever, maybe. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude.
If there's drama right after.
Here, let's do it. I'll be you with the one nut. Todd, you be some babe he's hooked up with.
Now, do you want me to have a dramatic
and we're out
reaction?
We're at dinner.
You want
no, we'll do it both ways. Yeah. We're at dinner, okay.
Where are you taking me?
Eastside Mario's.
Hey,
watch this. This is how you do it, dude. Take notes. You ready?
Okay.
Okay, I'm you.
I got something to talk to you about.
Yes,
it's pretty serious.
What would you like?
I just don't. I really like you and stuff, and so I don't want this to affect our relationship. But I feel like I'd be hiding something if I didn't tell you that I only have one testicle.
Really? No problem. Can I have the artichoke dip?
Okay.
Okay.
So there's that. Okay. And then there's this way.
Yeah.
So you and I are going into Eastside Mario's, right?
Yeah.
As we're walking in. Okay. And I'm going to open the door for you because we're dating.
Yeah.
It's gross. Oh, here, let me get the door for you.
Oh, thank you.
Whoa, I almost took off my last nut.
What?
Yeah, I only got one nut.
What do you mean you only have one nut?
Yeah, whatever. I had testicular cancer, so they whipped it off and I only got the one nut.
Can you have kids?
Yeah, totally. I bagged some jism.
Really?
Big time.
How do I get that?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Do you have to turkey baster or something?
No, well, dude, we're not getting married, so it doesn't matter, right?
I'm not a dude.
Okay. Chick. Well, that's what I call chick.
Okay, cool.
Babe,
okay, yeah.
Sweetheart.
Yeah.
Hey, bada boom, bada bing.
Really?
Sugar nuts. Yeah, yeah. I got some stuff on ice, so yeah, whenever I choose to have kids.
Can I have the artichoke dip to go?
See, dude, doesn't matter.
It's always the artichoke.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.